are all alone. Maybe the one who is waiting for you will prove untrue. Then what will you do? Maybe you'll sit and sigh, wishing that I were near. Then maybe, maybe, maybe.
War. War never changes. The Romans waged war to gather slaves and wealth. Spain built an empire from its lust for gold and territory. Hitler shaped a battered Germany into an economic superpower. But war never changes. In the 21st century, war was still waged over the resources that could be acquired. Only this time, the spoils of war were also its weapons, petroleum and uranium. For these resources, China would invade Alaska, the US would annex Canada, and the European Commonwealth would dissolve into quarreling, bickering nation states bent on controlling the last remaining resources on Earth. In 2077, the storm of world war had come again. In two brief hours, most of the planet was reduced to cinders. And from the ashes of nuclear devastation, a new civilization would struggle to arise. A few were able to reach the relative safety of the large underground vaults. Your family was part of that group that entered Vault 13. Imprisoned safely behind the large vault door, under a mountain of stone, a generation has lived without knowledge of the outside world. Life in the vault is about to change.
Ah, you're here. Good. We've got a problem. A big one. The controller chip for our water purification system has given up the ghost. Can't make another one, and the process is too complicated for a workaround system. Simply put, we're running out of drinking water. No water, no vault. This is crucial to our survival. And frankly, I think you're the only hope we have. You need to go find us another controller chip. We estimate we have 4 to 5 months before the vault runs out of water. We need that chip. We marked your map with the location of another vault. Not a bad place to start, I think. Look, just be safe, okay?
Hello and welcome to a new series of Sci-Fi Saturday. The plan for Sci-Fi Saturday so far is going to be the entire Fallout anthology, I guess. So Fallout 1, Fallout 2, Fallout 3, New Vegas, Fallout 4. I do not guarantee a complete playthrough in terms of all possible endings, the best ending for all the games, but I shall try my best. So, starting out on Fallout 1. Just left the vault. We've only clothes on our back. A 10mm. Seems to 10mm. Projector's hollow point and 24 armor piercing. Projector's hollow point does more damage but isn't as effective against armor. Armor piercing does less damage but isn't affected by armor. We have flares, which I don't completely know off the top of my head. We have stim packs, which heal. And we have knife. Would be a good backup. Unlike later games in the series, when Predator took over, this is turn-based. Or better or for worse, when it comes to a gameplay perspective. No, not gameplay. Viewer perspective. Now, if you really want to go quickly, there's the exit. But since we have the opportunity, we might as well try our best to get as many levels as we can as soon as we can. I'm trying to look up for a moment why that prop wasn't falling. Okay, how am I firing from point blank and yet still miss it? Push the rat. Let's see if we had a chance of hitting it. That was not the rat I was aiming for, but you know, can't complain if I hit something. Now, there was something here. I saw movement. Which means it's likely to attack me before I see it. I'm sure I saw something move that by here. Am I just going crazy? Maybe. Yeah, still. Over this way. There was a rat left over there. Well, I am likely to find out shortly. Yeah, there is a rat over there. For now, but always running back to on. Sprat walks towards us. We shoot. Hmm. good point to scout out where other rats are. I recall correctly, Fog of War is on, so I can't see areas I haven't explored. It seems really unfazed that I am walking up towards it. Gave the rat to a chance to attack me, but how? Oh, that. All the rats that we've seen so far. Down. One final check, just to be certain. And out we go. What just happened there? Oh, I add the weapon out, which, yeah. To the west, you can see a natural light. The first time in your life, you're looking at the outside world. Yeah. So, we have left Vault 13. And we wish to go over to Vault 15. Away we go. But along the way, we find a settlement. And we are asked to holster our weapon. Good day. I am called Seth. How can I help you? I'd like some information. Information? What do you want to know about? I want to know about this place. Shady Sands is a peaceful community. We have our own irrigation system, so we can grow our own food. If we were not plagued with raiders and rat scorpions, we'd have no problem. Let's ask about the rat scorpions. Those damn rat scorpions have been after our Brahmins since we moved here. Not a week goes by that someone doesn't get poison trying to keep them out. It depends. Last week they took my brother Jarvis. Raslow, our doctor, is looking for an antidote. As quickly as he can. Hey, you have the means to help us. Why didn't you go talk to our leader, Aradesh? I assume if I ask, I want to know more about this place, it will lead back to this. I want to know about the raiders. There are several groups of raiders. I organize guards like Ian to help fight them off. There is one band to the southeast of here. Watch out for them. For now, we'll stay away from the Red Scorpion Caves, but perhaps. You should speak to Aradesh, our leader. He likes to meet all of our visitors. He should be in our town hall, the building to the south. Trina. Welcome to Shady Sands, Traveller. My name is Katrina. My job is to greet strangers and help them understand our village. We find that there are fewer problems if you listen to what I have to say. Tell me about yourself. My life was very boring. I was raised in a vault. I lived there for many years. Unfortunately, we were crowded and life was very bad. There was a schism and many people left, taking with them the best equipment. Still, some of us tried to stay in the vault, but then we were attacked. I was hurt and I ended up here. Now I try to help people. Where can I get some better equipment? You have to do like we do. Scavenge it or trade it for it. And if you're attacked, your foes might provide equipment if you live long enough to loot them. We are a peaceful community, so we mostly barter or trade for the items we cannot produce. Tell me about this place. You're standing in Shady Sands. We're but a small town in a large world. We just want to be left alone. Besides, some mutated animals and other creatures of the desert, only the raiders give us trouble. Aradesh is our leader. He is in the large central house. Speak to him. Tell me about the rest of the world. I know very little of the outside world. I escaped from a vault when it was attacked. Unfortunately, I was very hurt and do not remember much of what happened. But Tahama was watching over me, and I was found by the people of Shady Sands. I live here now. Have you spoken with Ian yet? He's a merchant guard who was hurt. He is recovering in the guardhouse over there. He points to the east. He has more widely travelled than I. Where was this vault of yours? It was Vault 15. It is due east of here. We tried to make contact with some other vaults, but we always failed. I think it was the raiders who attacked my fellow dwellers. Be careful. That's all for now. Thanks. So, Katrina came from Vault 15. And it was attacked. Shady Sands guard. And a short, stacky man. Hello. Hello, stranger. You look like you're new here. What's your name? I'm Albert. This is one of the default characters. Yeah. Good to meet you. I'm Ian. What do you do here? I was a guard for the merchants of the hub. However, I was shot during a raid by bandits. I've been staying here since the people have helped me recover. Still, my knowledge of the outside world and my experience make me useful here. Shady Sands is my home now. Occasionally I even get to visit Junktown or the Hub to do some trading, since I'm the only person here who has ever really left town. I'm sorry to hear about your injury. Thanks, it's healed up well, thanks to Raslo. Tell me about the raiders. There are three groups, the Khans, the Vipers, and the Jackals. They pretty much hate each other, but they all raid Shady Sands. Tell me more about Shady Sands. Shade Sands is a small but self-sufficient community. The only trouble here is with the bandits and Rat Scorpions. Why are the Rat Scorpions trouble? Rat Scorpions are very dangerous. They have a poisonous stinger in the tail, and they are very quick. Aradesh has been trying to find a way to get rid of them. If you feel brave, you can talk to Aradesh about them. Thank you. Seth, if I recall correctly, was the guard there. Tell me about Seth. Seth is a very brave fighter. He occasionally goes to the Rat Scorpion Caves to kill a few Rat Scorpions, but they always wind up coming back. There are just too many of them to fight. And that will lead us back to a very dangerous because poisonous tiger. Can you give me directions to the hub in Junktown? The hub is a big trading center far south of Shady Sands. It's run by several different caravan groups of merchants. The Water Merchants, Crimson Caravan, and the Fargo Traders. Junktown is a little south and a ways west. It's smaller, but still a good place to drop in for a drink. It's overseen by a fellow by the name of Killian Darkwater, the local shopkeeper, sheriff, and mayor. Thank you. Could you help me out a bit? Your experience would be useful. Let's go. It'll be good to get back into action. So now we have Ian as our companion. What weapons are you skilled with? I'm a good shot with just about any sort of pistol, and I can use a submachine gun too. I also know how to handle a knife. Sparta. So, on his person, he has ammo and no weapons. So, I give him a knife. Wait for 40 caps. Yeah. So now he has a knife at the very least. So, nothing. Never mind, Ian. So in the center of Shady Sands, we see a pillar. This pillar shows the showpiece of Shady Sands Square. It tells stories to remind the people of hope and peace. We have a guardhouse there. Here we have a house, but no one is staying there. Oh, yeah, Ian's in the way. I was trying to work out why I couldn't move down here. So, dog. Currently night, but let's try to talk to it. It's late. Come back in the morning. Okay. Well, we're not hurt. You will be if you keep me from my sleep. I'll come back in the morning. Okay. We'll head away. And corner room, you see Paradesh.
Greetings. Your business in Shady Sands might be...
I'm from a vault to the west. My people are dying of thirst. I need to find a water purifier chip for them to survive.
Wanderer, I shall believe you for now. You may enter Shady Sands, but be warned, your every move will be watched.
I was wondering if I could ask you a few questions.
Certainly. What do you wish to know?
What can you tell me about the other towns around here?
Junktown lies south of here, though there is little in the way of visitation. From stories, I'm certain there are cities south of that.
Thanks. I can ask you a few more questions.
Certainly. What do you wish to know?
What's going on around here?
Oh my, yes. Great packs of rad scorpions are killing our herds. We don't know where they're from, and no matter how many we kill, there's always more.
Go on.
And now the monsters are attacking my people. Roslo is trying to find a cure for their poison, but I'm not sure how it goes.
Well, I'll help you get rid of those things.
Yes. Please, talk to Roslo. He possesses far more information on these creatures than I.
Okay. Okay. I believe. I'm too busy to talk right now. To get this meal ready. That smells really good. I bet it tastes great. Why, thank you. I'm sure you will enjoy it. Thanks for the compliment. I can tell my friends about you. Interesting. So. I suppose we must wait until morning. No one else around to talk to him. Open the pit boy. Rest until morning. 144 days left. Can I help you? What do you know about rad scorpions? Not too much. They seem to be extremely large versions of the North American Emperor Scorpion. Contrary to my medical knowledge, their poison is grown more potent, not diluted, as I would expect. Seth has been hunting them, which helps some of my tests. And how can such a large creature even be possible by natural evolution? Or even radiation-induced mutation is beyond me. You seem well-educated. What are you doing here? Doc Morbid in Junktown taught me some. And just because we live in stone huts does not mean we are less intelligent or educated. Have a nice day. Oh, I'm sorry? Continue down the street. Anything else? They seem to be sensitive to light, nocturnal. If I could get a sample of their poison, especially the venom produced in the sac located in their tail, create an anti-venom. Thanks. I'm not in need of healing. And yes, that's it. So.
Hi. I heard there was a traveler in town, but I was kind of skeptical until I saw you. My name's Tandy. What's yours?
My name's Albert.
Well, how do you like our little town? Bored yet?
It's okay. Can I ask you a few questions, though?
Sure, I guess. I've never been out of here, so I don't know what help I can be. So, what you need?
What else is around these parts?
There's a bunch of cities down south, but since you're such a great traveler, I'm sure you know that already.
Thanks.
No problem. Anything else?
What's going on around here?
Same as always. Boring.
Have you heard any stories from down south?
Just stuff. No problem. Anything else?
How do you like it here?
It's okay, I guess. I mean, it is home and all, but it's so boring. You know, I want to see the world.
If you're so bored, why don't you leave?
Me? Leave? I wish. I don't know enough to leave alone. No one else wants to go. Worst of all, my father says he would have a heart attack if something happened to me.
Tough situation. Can I ask you a few questions?
Sure, I guess. I've never been out of here, so I don't know what help I can be. So, what you need?
I think that's it. That's about it. Thanks for your time.
Well, Thanks for talking. We don't get many strangers here, so it's always good to talk to new people. See ya.
Bye. So, let's talk to Seth, since he knows where the Rad Scorpion Caves are. Take me to the Rad Scorpion Caves. You sure you want me to give you direction to the Rad Scorpion Caves? I can't go, but I can show you the way. Yes. So, here we are, at the Rad Scorpion Caves. And I'm gonna end it here. So, if you liked this video, like, subscribe, comment. If you didn't like this video, comment saying why you didn't like this video. As is Sci-Fi Saturday, the next episode will appear next Saturday. So, I hope to see you all then.